Hi, John Knox Village family. This is Steve, here to do another behind the scenes video. And today we've got a special one. You might have been over here at Places already and seen the robot that's been moving around in Places restaurant. We're here today to have a chat with Todd Hollander. We're gonna go back here now and ask a few questions and find out what this is all about. Let's go. So hi Todd, how are you doing today?
Doing great, Steve, how are you?
I'm doing fantastic. Thanks for taking the time to talk to us about this new robot we've got over here at Places. Very exciting stuff so far. We've seen it out there running around and it seems to be taking on its own personality out there.
It definitely is. It's a new associate for Places. We're hoping to be able to offer it a job soon.
So how did it become a new associate here at Places? How did it all happen?
Well, it's really funny. I network with a lot of different communities out there, and I was looking at a different project that I'm working on, and we got talking about the short staff that we both were seeing and how we're trying to solve the problem of people just not applying for the positions. And the person I was talking to mentioned that they looked at this robot and it wasn't a good fit for their community because their tables are really too tight and it would have a hard time maneuvering. And you know, what I've been trying to solve in my head is how we can make things at Places more efficient. Right now we're at 25-30% carryout orders, and that's a lot to move from the kitchen to the host stand. And as my friend and I were talking about the robot and what it can do, it seemed like the perfect solution. And so far it's proven to be very helpful.
Okay, yeah, we saw it yesterday. We came by to take some pictures and some video, which we're gonna see it running around a little bit as we cut to that video here in just a second. But explain to us, what would a robot actually do and how does it operate?
Well, the main purpose of this robot is to carry things, and that's what it does. You can see that it has three different shelves. There's actually a bucket down at this lower level as well that you can put things in. If he becomes a he or she, it's non-binary. If the robot becomes a permanent associate here at Places, we'll get a second bucket to go on top as well. So it basically operates, you load it up with whatever you need. It has all these different points. There's 10 different points that it can go to. You would hit it and hit go, and then it connects to the internet, looks at the map, and knows exactly what route to take. And as there's obstacles in front of it, or even if it's a person walking a little bit slower, it will pause or stop or slow its pace down to walk with that person and not bump into anything.
So we saw it when we were filming it yesterday, moving around, we saw it kind of go to the host stand, dropping off to-go orders, and then once those orders are picked up, it knows to go back to the kitchen. So is there some kind of programming that had to happen to tell it where to go?
It is. Bear Robotics has each of these buttons programmed. So for instance, when you're back in the kitchen, you would hit to-go, hit the go button, it knows to go out the correct door, up the side of the restaurant, and over to the host stand, and it will stop there and say, please take your food. And it will continue repeating that until the host takes off all of the food, and then the host actually has to go ahead then and tell it where to go next. Most of the time it's going to go back to Expo, which will be the kitchen line, but sometimes the server may need some extra help bussing a table. So again, there's 8 different points within the restaurant itself where the robot can go that you can put the dirty dishes on, and then you would hit dish, or actually it says wash, and then it will go back to the dish area for someone to unload.
So you've answered part of my next question, but I wanted to know, how does this affect the role of current staff?
Well, it really has solved a big issue of ours, which is efficiency. We've cut down on having a person dedicated just to run food, run to-go packages from point A to point B. So that person can really focus on touch points with guests. So that person can be dedicated to be at the host stand and really greet people when they come in as they should. You know, if it's a server that's running that role, that server can take tables so that we can have more tables open and available. It's really helped make sure that we're really focusing in on the guests and taking away some of those routine point A to point B steps.
Obviously, this is a fantastic, exciting venture for us here at the Village.
Yes.
How did this come about in the very first place? How did we decide to even get this in here?
Yeah, as I mentioned, I was networking and talked about it, and it just seemed to fit. The cost of the robot is equivalent of one 40-hour FTE server. So by not filling that server position that we have posted and that we're not getting applicants for anyway, it's kind of a wash on the financial side. But the benefit of it is it's not going to call out sick. The robot's not going to need benefits. It can work more than 40 hours and not get paid overtime. So it's really beneficial. And as I was talking to my friend that had looked at this, it just seemed like the perfect fit here. And then there's opportunity to expand it to some of the other restaurants that are dealing with some of the same challenges as well. Meadows would be an example. That's probably, if this works and we decide as an organization that we're going to move forward and get a second robot, that's probably where the second one will go, to help keep the servers at Stories and the bartender at Stories Public House in Stories Public House and have this run the food from point A to point B.
So if this thing works out and everybody's happy with it, and you know, everybody just loves this thing from they've seen it so far, we could see this across multiple areas of the Village.
Absolutely. And then what I'm hoping to find as well, for instance, over at the care center, we push carts down the long hallways from the kitchen to the different halls or neighborhoods at the care center. I'm hoping to be able to find, this wouldn't be the right solution, but I'm hoping we'll be able to find more network to get a robot that will be able to push the carts for us, so we don't have a dedicated person that does that.
So tell us a bit more about the reaction from residents and associates. When we were here yesterday, you could see the residents just smiling and so happy to see this thing walking around. And you know, you said earlier that you didn't know how the reaction was going to be, but what is it? What have you seen?
Well, when I first started exploring this and talking to staff and residents, there was some definite hesitation. Is it going to take away those touch points? Are we replacing people with robots? It's kind of scary. I think, you know, we all see in the movies like iRobot and a few others where the robots take over the world and it's a bad thing, Terminator, I'll be back. But in this instance, I think it really helps. And once people see it and understand, that attitude is completely changed. Associates love it. They like testing it and seeing how far they can push the robot, not literally, but figuratively. The residents enjoy watching it in action, feel that we're really cutting edge by having it here. I had one resident stop me yesterday, and she's been telling all of her friends, and they're like, oh, really? John Knox has a robot? That's so neat. And they are really looking at solutions and being innovative. I had another resident that even just mentioned the noise that it makes, that it's pleasant and loves how the robot sings as it goes by. It's a lot of good interest right now, especially since it's new, but we have residents that are coming over to places now just to see it in action.
Yeah, and I was actually speaking to our printer for the Village Voice yesterday, and I told him about it, and he said he's going to bring his grandkids over to see this thing.
That's great.
He thought they would get a kick out of it. So yeah, there's a lot of excitement, and it's definitely great to see the buzz around this robot here at Places Restaurant. And thanks for answering my questions today, Todd.
You're welcome, Steve. I appreciate it. We're very happy to have the robot, and should it become a permanent fixture, then we'll start having a naming contest between residents and staff, and we'll come up with a good name for it.
Yeah, we'll send some communication out about that, so residents and associates can keep a lookout for that in the future. Thanks a lot for answering my questions today, Todd. We hope you have a great day.
Thank you. You as well, Steve.
We'll see you later.
All right. Bye-bye.